name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you, and also with you.
Let us come before God, confessing our brokenness, the ways we wound our life, the lives of others, and the life of the world, and asking for God's mercy and forgiveness. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. God, our refuge and strength, close at hand in our distress, meet us in our sorrow, and lift up our eyes to the peace and light of your constant care. Help us so to hear your word of grace, that our fear will be dispelled by your love, our desolation eased by your presence, and our hope renewed by your promises, in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
My soul is bereft of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. So I say, gone is my glory, and all that I had hoped from the Lord. The thought of my affliction and my homelessness is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it and is bowed down within me. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness.
From the Gospel according to John, beginning at the 14th chapter, the first verse. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. At St. Mary's Primary School, we have a new way of talking with the children about life and about our spiritual life. We talk about the ows and the wows. Ow, those times which feel so hard when we feel hurt or alone or sad. And then the things that give us joy and delight, the wows of life. I don't know about you, but I do find that language helpful. It's an important life lesson, isn't it? As we journey through this life we are given, we encounter these times of sorrow and times of joy. Tonight is about the ows. The heart of our service is the painful, painful loss of bereavement. That saying goodbye when we don't want to. The death of our loved ones. Of course, what we hope for is a good death, a long life well lived, passing away peacefully. Yet so often that hasn't been or can't be the case. The death itself, bringing painful circumstances, the tragedy of a life cut short or never begun, the trauma of a sudden death, the distress of long illnesses. And over these past 18 months, in circumstances which have been often so hard, as people have said to me, this is not how I imagined it, for the death or the funeral. I know for me that moment was particularly my mum dying in hospital in April 2020. Only one person allowed to visit her for an hour or so the night before she died. My mum lived for her vast and ever-growing family, and we couldn't be with her. But that's only my story. I know tonight there are so many people with their own story of heartbreak. And in all of this, we experience the desolation of grief and loss. Our first reading from the Song of Lamentations is so poignant. My soul is bereft of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. Gone is all that I hoped for. I only have bitterness and sorrow, and my soul is bowed down within me. And we weep. The word desolation has its roots in the Latin desolare, to abandon. And this is so often how we feel in bereavement. We feel alone, disconnected from a world around us where people are just carrying on with their lives and crying out to God. Do you really care? Why have you forsaken us? Why have you done this to us? As we do this, in this desolation, in this weeping, if we allow it, we can come to know that we are not alone. We know that our weeping, our desolation is shared by family and friends, those who sorrow with us, and those
those who sorrow for us, those for whom this is not a bereavement personally, but stand by us and comfort us and sorrow for us. They are a godsend, and we give thanks tonight for all the comfort and support we've received from others. But also, in that weeping, in that desolation, you will hear Jesus Christ. In his ministry here on earth, Jesus met so many who were experiencing loss in their lives. Parents whose children had died, people who felt lost, rejected, men and women who'd known great emotional, physical pain. Jesus showed compassion and he grieved with them. He often stopped along the way to comfort people in their hurts. He ached over their sufferings. He took pity on them, as Matthew tells us in chapter 14. He took pity on them and he healed them. And that last bit does really matter. That healing matters. I promise you it's not about time being a great healer. It's to know that Jesus longs for us to find consolation. In our second reading tonight, Jesus has gathered with his friends for their final meal together. Jesus is facing his own death, and he knows the sadness and the ache in their hearts. And Jesus makes that promise. I will not abandon you. I will go away, yes, but I will come back again, and I will be with you always. And then his invitation. In all the sorrows of life, in all those hours, know me as your path, the way to walk. The way to walk where you will be surrounded by comfort and my peace. Know me as the truth that only God's love and light are for everlasting. And know me as the life. Jesus is our good shepherd, the one we sung about in Psalm 23. He walks alongside us when we find ourselves in the valley of the shadow of death. But he walks alongside us and by his grace through that dark place. Not to stay there, but to find restoration and consolation, to find healing, to come to that place where we can know, perhaps just as a glimpse to start, but then over time coming to know the joy and delight of being alive, to find the wells of life. This is my prayer for all of us tonight. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah.
Now we come to the time of commemorating those who have died. And as the names are lit, as the names are read, Karen will read it, for each one will remember tonight. Now, Lord Father, we remember before you all those we have loved and lost. We give you thanks for their lives and commit them to your care. Their pilgrim hearts return to you, to joy.
Duncan Adam, Diana Akers, Rupert Asker, Mary Arnold with Richard Avis, Alan Bailey, Harold Baker, George Ballinger with Ethel Mary Ballinger, Tony Bays, Jeff Bird, June Bowie, Winifred Bray, Jennifer Bridgman, Vera Bromley with Perry Bromley, Sheila Brunston, Joan Carwardine with Desmond Carwardine, Pamela Chin, Julia Clapton, Sonny Cleaver, Francis Compton.
Patricia Dent with Rufus Dent, Siv Dibben, George Douse, Belinda Drew, John Drew with Christine Drew, Tony Dyer with Christine Dyer, Fran Eddles, Ted Ely with Betty Ely, Lou Evans, Douglas Fisher with Phyllis Fisher, Peter Fortin, Brian Freeman with Doreen Freeman, Alan French, Helen Garrod, Colin G, Patricia Gibbons and Peter Gibbons with Rachel, Angela Giddens, Edwin Gilman, Lionel and Hilda Glass, Dennis Goodfield, Doreen Grimwood with Anthony Grimwood, Jeff Haynes,
Yordis Halliwell, Liz Harrison, Elizabeth Harvey, Madeline Hassel, Anthony Hawkins, Colonel Peter Hervey, Hazel Hill with Desmond Hill, David Holborough with Margot Holborough, Diran Hunanian, Anne Inskip, John Johnson, Anthony Jones, Paul King, Joan Kimber, Stephen Kirby, David Curtin, Mike Niffton with Kevin Niffton, George Cordula, Gladys Cranmer with James Cranmer,
John Lamb with Dylan Lamb, Pauline Lee, Verity Lloyd with Charlie Walsh, Joyce Lodwick with Victor Lodwick, Anthony Losley Williams, Yvonne Lowe, Dan Marks Bryan, Helen McAlpine, Michael McInnery,
Helen Mosdell, with Alan Mosdell. Simon Murray Wells, Gerard Newman, and John Newman, with Ermengarde Newman. Bobby Nicole, Charles Nichols, Betty Oakley, Jilly Payne, with David Payne, Jerry Parton, Jean Parton, Victoria Passy, Sandra Pithy, Stephen Pocket, Jill Poppleton, with Ron Poppleton and Kenneth, Claire Potter, John Powney, John Price, Kenneth Pride.
Pat Rees, Gracie Richardson, Marilyn Rice, Rose Rice, with Alan Rice, Brian Ringrose, with Margaret Ringrose, Phil Sanders, Peter Sanderson, Dennis Scales, Sean Scottford, Barbara Seal, Marion Selwood, with Gordon Selwood, John and Kathleen Shepherd, Pauline Sleet, Bob Smith, Dinah Smith, Mary Smith, Michael and Jill Smith, Nigel Smith, Rosemary Smith, with Graham Smith Priest, Michael Sparrowhawk, Julie Spruels, Dr. Theo Stenning, Gloria Stephen, Vera Stevens, with Robin Stevens, Lady Miranda Stockton, Pamela Stockfis, Michael Stone, David Story,
Joan Thomas, Enid Thomas, Stuart Tildesley, Christopher Timmins, Sharon True, Baby Fred Truscott Jones, Robert Watts, Christopher Weston, Keith Wilde, Hazel Wilkinson, Vincent Woodman.
This is the will of him that sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, and I will raise them up at the last day.
Thank you.
come now to our prayers of intercession. If you would like to join in with the singing of the response, you're very willing to do so. With faith and love and in unison with Christ, let us offer our prayers before the throne of grace. Have mercy on your people and teach us your ways of love and peace. Torn apart by division. Comfort all those who suffer and hear those who cry out in pain and desolation. Dying and sustain them with the knowledge of your love. Give rest to the departed and bring them with all your saints to glory everlasting. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
let us pray. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. God give you his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Neither death nor life can separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Thanks be to God.